Morning to you on this Sunday. I'm Lynn Smith, and we do begin with that breaking news this morning. North Korea says it has carried out its largest nuclear test ever, and it has successfully detonated a hydrogen bomb. Texas say they are closer to getting clean water flowing to that city. President Trump is back at the White House this morning after surveying flood-ravaged areas, and church service might be the answer for many Harvey victims. So our coverage of the storm's aftermath will continue with a pastor who is headed back to the pulpit today after turning his sanctuary into a shelter. But we do have other headlines to get to this morning. A wildfire is threatening hundreds of homes in Burbank, Glendale, and other areas of Los Angeles. Well, there is no evidence that former President Obama wiretapped Trump Tower before the 2016 election. That is what the Justice Department is saying in new court documents. You may remember Harvey by shopping. 25% of profile. Some advice on how to best help. Good morning to you.
Morning.
It's sad to even think that anyone would take advantage of a situation like this. But there are scammers. We've seen it in previous tragedy. So what do people need to know about where their money is going that's going to actually help people?
Well, the first
donated. Are there steps afterward that you need to take?
Well, for people end of 2017, you will need those receipts.
And when you are donating to a charity that you feel comfortable with, are there questions you need to ask?
Well, I think the most important thing is does it qualify for tax exempt?
And we've heard from different places that there are certain things that are needed. Is it money or are they material items like clothes, diapers, things like that? What
well,
do you recommend?
I mean, the best way that you can help people in
Houston. Oh, thanks so much. Well, to find out, good morning, everyone. On this Sunday, I'm Lynn Smith. You're watching HLN News that hits home. First things first, a look at your headlines. World leaders are strongly condemning North Korea this morning after it claims it successfully tested a hydrogen bomb that's ready to be mounted on an intercontinental ballistic missile. One seismic monitoring group estimates the blast at 120 kilotons. South Korea saying it's more like 50 kilotons. Nevertheless, that would be 8 times greater than the atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima. The standing floodwaters in Texas may contain toxic waste. The EPA says Hurricane Harvey flooded or damaged at least 13 sites with industrial waste from places like gas and pesticide companies. So the EPA workers say they can't actually reach these areas on the ground until the water recedes. And today, rescue teams will try to evacuate 140 hikers trapped between two fires in Oregon. Rescuers say they will lead the hikers 14 miles around the flames to get them to a new trail. More now that he was just a teacher, but to thousands of fans, Eddie B is a comedian. His YouTube videos are about life in the classroom, and they've gone viral. Take a look. Clips showing the teacher that has turned into a social media sensation. Eddie B, earlier I sat down with him to get his hilarious take on life in the classroom and why it's resonating. These videos have had millions and millions of views. You are no longer teaching. You're actually out on the circuit doing comedian or doing tours that have completely sold out. Why do you think this is resonating so much with so many teachers?
I think